do wonder at times, have I done enough? And I think of that hymn that says, I wonder, have I done my best for Jesus, who died upon the cruel tree, who gave his life on Calvary that I might be set free. I've been involved in this ministry a long time, starting with my parents who were Christians and believed in Christ being necessary as a personal savior. And so I learned about evangelism from my dad, because whenever somebody would come to the house, he'd invariably be talking to them about Jesus. I was born in Minneapolis in 1924. I began sharing my life story with others on a job when I started working as a mechanical engineer.
He has a heart for the lost.
People around me needed to know about Jesus.
But when I heard that Chuck was leading a Bible study, I was very intrigued.
My wife was involved in this ministry along with me.
I think of a couple who were involved together in a number of different ways with CBMC ministry. They were involved as hosts for couples conferences. They were involved as hosts for couples banquets. They would sing together at sweetheart banquets.
He and my mom always invited people into their home. They counseled them. They instructed them.
We started a new firm that was going to use waste materials to produce a gas that would replace natural gas. My wife, at the very beginning, she said to me, what if it doesn't work? Very encouraging. My wife found a verse in the Bible that was a great encouragement. It was Psalm 55:22. It says, cast your burden upon the Lord, and he will sustain you.
He was as solid as a rock in the faith. He was an example. He was a man that could weather a storm and the rest of us are drowning.
I always go back to his final command where Jesus said, go and make disciples.
He was always discipling at least two guys.
He didn't say just make church members, just don't make choir members and ushers, but he said make disciples.
He's still discipling men now.
In 1980, Operation Timothy was presented to us, rank and file people in CBMC, and I got a hold of it right away and started discipling other men and teaching them the Word of God.
And he encouraged me to participate in Operation Timothy as a way of growing my faith. And at that time it was 4 books, first steps, and then three books to follow. And so I went through that, and it had a huge impact in my life.
Evangelism is nothing more than just sharing out of your own life. You've read the Bible, and you talk to others about the Bible, how important it is. It's an incredible book.
The kind of guy who was always turning conversations naturally in the spiritual direction.
We as Christians are called to be witnesses of what's happened in our own lives.
Chuck agreed to pray for me daily, to be there for me and be a prayer partner.
God really answers prayer, so I just want to praise him for what he's done in my life. I started memorizing scripture early on.
I'm really impressed by Chuck's knowledge of the Bible. He's familiar with so many passages, and we tease him sometimes, asking him if he was present at some of the events. But a year ago, it took us about a month for some of us to learn Philippians 4:13. In contrast, Chuck knows about half of the New Testament, and I'm not exaggerating. We don't need a concordance when we have Chuck at our Bible study.
One of the assignments was to memorize Psalm 91, the entire chapter. And so I did, and that was the beginning of my experience in memorizing scripture.
Oftentimes when the subject matter would come up at a leadership meeting, Chuck would have a verse or a passage to refer to that could help us through the question at hand.
He brings supernatural wisdom to the table.
3 things have been real important to me in my Christian life. It's to read the Word of God, to be in the Word of God, and to memorize the Word of God.
Chuck, I just want you to stay humble like you are and continue to share the best news in life.
I'm very proud of you. Congratulations.
I just rejoice, Chuck, in the impact that you've had in the lives of businessmen in the marketplace.
For your faithfulness, your solidness, and your example to me of how not to hesitate and stumble in my faith.
On behalf of Maplewood CBMC, I would like to thank God for giving us Chuck Eumurian.
Go up, introduce yourself to Chuck, say hello, and spend a minute with a guy who's as quality as there is in this ministry. And dear brother in Christ, dear son of God.
You have honored God through your whole life and as an example to other men. My heartfelt congratulations to you on receiving this award.
We are very proud of you. We are overwhelmed by the fact that you're receiving this great award, and we just want to say we love you. Thanks for being our dad.
I wonder, have I done my best for Jesus?